you.
Head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in
I'm
the game.
I'm whipping in track hard with messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it too real ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. La mama went thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelce, I be having emotions. Just like a lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it over. I'm 30, we give up the score no more, man.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like I scored again, diamonds on them dance. I can hear the music playing with them bands. Crowd going wild, dived in the fans. I'm locking in on a mission, I tell them my vision. You young as she get like me. I got your shorty, she with me. I gave her a jersey, I told her to join my team. It's best you go where it's safe, you know how I play. I get to a sack like Frank. You can teach money to fly, I turn it a hop. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy, I'm used to the lights, I'm shining so bright. It's visor to cover my face. You see me working, I'm working, I'm getting it done. As soon they be feeding me grapes.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head
they
in the game.
They screaming my name when I walk in the building. Yellow diamonds on me like I play for the Steelers. I'm in the field, yup, just like a Steeler. Oh, this your girl, my bae had the Steeler. I hop on the beat and I float like a real. I caught a TD, yeah, right across the middle. I'm speaking banks, boy, you telling riddles. Can't hang with the gang, so we had to sit around. Down, I'm in LA, right around and around. My dog just called, say he's in a touchdown. When I call a play, you won't hear a sound. Hold up, hold up, hold up. Money calling right now. I gotta go and get it, and it don't matter how. All I know is, man, yeah, I'm 10 toes down. I keep my head high and my eyes on the prize. Yeah, my feet on the ground.
Let's go, go, let's go. I told my boss, it ain't no limits. No. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Yeah. Turn down right now. Two don't make bad to get around right now.
Okay, say no more. Tell the chauffeur to open Mercedes door. Put the pedal to metal and made it soar. She was, but I made it sure. It was, so we stayed indoors. Let's take it where no one has been before. It feel like I've known you some years before, but I don't know.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply rapidocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we are. Swing out of life. I'm doing big things in my life. I deserve 6 rings like a Mike. I've got a no sleep. I remember when it was the nosebleeds. Now they captured the fashion from flow seats. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it.
Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it.
Nobody really cares. insomniac for sleeping all night. It's a bad soundtrack. Read the script. Born in the motherland, headed straight down to the south. Tennessee mornings with pops, working three jobs. I knew that they struggled to get it. That's why I wanted to get it. That's embedded, you get it? Treat it like a law. And I'ma need commission for this hit. Lance laid the canvas and I painted over it. I don't need a vision board to show you I'm the I'm betting on myself. Count the chips. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest. Try to sink my ship like Titanic and leave me with Jack. Hope I be panicking, but I rose to the top. Isn't it funny that the is built like a Maserati, yoga folding like origami? What? I walk the walk. I talk the talk. I be saying what I want. When I had no deposit, closet was looking real bare. Now I made a deposit, my closet's looking super rare. Drove it really far. Crazy how did this happen, wishing on a star. It's a celebration, I ain't talking Mardi Gras. With a little patience, you'll be eating Buddha Khan. What you want? What you want? Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest. Never let a manufacturer stack like that. And if you get intoxicated, tell the boy fall back. If it was back then, I'd be tripping off that. Took a little time just to get me on track. I went from snotty to snobby, got it like, immune to everybody, this is start 101. Up in the club, throwing the 50s like, hated to love it, I just can't get enough. Labels keep calling me, I said move if you call me, please, or don't even bother me. They said, oh my apologies, they keep calling and calling. I keep stalling and stalling. Rookie of the year, my career's no falling. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin. Just being honest.
You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. Yeah, I jump out the booth. Then I might hop through the roof. Count all the rings, stuff. My team is the truth, but they some lies to you. And they never sing, huh? But they always shoot. And all of their diamonds are new. And that's why I'm here with villain, cause I really get it. And I need all my honeys in blue. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got the boom. You gotta choose. Make a choice. I need 100 pack for my boys. Deep be hating and talking and talking and hating. I bet you I kill the noise. I've been a man like I'm painting. I boost up my rating. You know how I play with toys. Pop out on any occasion. Get standing ovations. They can't help it but rejoice. They all wanna follow me. Cause I got my foot on the opposition neck and ain't no apologies. 100 yards, you know I own all the property. Daddy's home, you know I own all the property. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like to lose. Make a move. Been at the bottom, I got to prove. You gotta choose.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Tonight we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Chicago Bears and the Philadelphia Eagles. Two teams here fresh off week one victories. Who can keep it going as we're underway on EA Sports? And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Fake the handoff, now Fields. Got an open man here, it's KJ Hamler. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one goes for 24 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So one play and they're already just shy of midfield. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. First down, it's Fields. That's caught by Montgomery. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now Fields. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. So they will tread backward on the holding penalty.
And I know that they're going to get coached up and they'll get yelled out a little bit, but let's face it, it is hard not to do at the speed and pace that they play.
Here's Fields. And this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
In motion, the tight end. Throwing on second and 14. Fields over the middle, and that's caught by Kmet. Touchdown, Chicago! Cole Kmet, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Bears put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. This will be fielded inside the five. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at the 20. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And nothing doing on his first run. Back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. In on the stop, the former Georgia Bulldog, Roquan Smith. This defense for the Bears, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. Jackson picks it, and the Bears are going to take possession of the football. So a first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back, and he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Play action. It's Fields. Takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Fields, we know he has the good mobility. He flashes it there as he scrambles for the first down. First carry now for David Montgomery. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, the gap man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
In motion goes the tight end. Throwing on third down, Fields. Open man, he finds Komet. Touchdown, Chicago. A great effort there. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bears are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. Pinheiro now to add the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. From way up at the 23. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
Come on, come on.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now.
And they run the option here on first and 10. Hurts fumbles it, and this is picked up by the Bears. Past the 20. And they bring this one back. A fumble return for a Bears touchdown. Well, Charles, not only did they fumble the football, but they're starting to fumble away their chances here a little bit. We've got a three-score ball game now here in the first half.
And the last thing you want to do, partner, is help the other team with what are avoidable turnovers. You want to hang on to the football because you're already playing against a good team. You're just making it easier for them by giving them extra opportunities.
This will be fielded inside the five. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Okay, ready.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Ranger.
Throwing is Hurts. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. He's got a man complete. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. An option handoff given to Sanders. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Here's Hurts to throw. He finds his man complete. It's McDonald. And they move this all the way down to the 9. That one goes for 30 yards.
We spent a lot of time talking about what's going on the field. How about off the field with the evaluation? And they spent a lot of time saying, we've got to get a rookie in here who has big playability. And that's exactly what we're seeing here early in his career.
Drafted him in the spring. Here he is early in the fall making an impact. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. But looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
Against a team coming off a win, just as your team did the previous week, you talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Hurts. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game. And now, it brings up fourth down.
And this one is right through. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So that kick gives them their first points of the game, CD. And it comes on the third drive, but hopefully for them that's a spark that gets that offense going.
Yeah, and I would say if you're the offensive play caller, as you look at your sheet, you're trying to find that part on there that unlocks bigger points. They've struggled with a few drives so far. Finally got three out of it. How do you find the end zone? That's what he's searching for now.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in the touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it. And afterwards, they'll say, there's never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
One play action, Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. Give him 32 on the play.
You ask tight ends about their favorite routes to run, and surprisingly, this will pop up as one of their staples because they run so many routes in the middle of the field. How about this one? Starts downfield, bends it to the corner, great touch on the football, and they turn that one into a big play.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Play action, Fields. He'll buy some time right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
They haven't been able to stop them so far this series, but getting a nice little stand from their defense now.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. A shotgun snap, Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagle 17-yard line. Mark that down as a pickup of 13, and the Bears have the first.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of deck.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Absolutely a golden opportunity missed there to add to their lead and really cap off an impressive drive because they've got the advantage and plenty of time to add to it. But on the flip side, plenty of time for an opposing comeback as well. So when you have the chance to distance yourself and out ditch so early, partner, you know you don't want to let it slip away.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
From the 22, Hurts looking left side for Watkins, and he's got him. That'll go for a gain of 7. And now 1 yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Beating him there with his legs. 21 yards, first down.
Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it. Most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This is caught. Touchdown, Eagles! A.J. Brown, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. Point after, right down the middle. And it makes the score 21-10. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success. Yes, there are things to build on because they found some play calls that worked. Now, they've got to build another drive and find a way to avoid the turnover that plagued it on the last one.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. From the gun, here's Fields. This pass caught by Hamler. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 22 yards there, a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. A play fake, now Fields to throw. And that's caught inside the 35. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Going on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, it looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
To throw again on second down, Fields. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
He's got a man here. It's Montgomery. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 17-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
They'll send a receiver in motion left. 2nd and 10. Fields again. Fields hit, and the ball is loose. And it's picked up by the Eagles. He's at the 50, the 30, 10, 5, and he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return, an Eagle touchdown. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return and everyone tries to find someone to block and bring it all the way home?
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
Take it in at the 3. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And in just about every game we see, partner, what do? When we look at the stat sheet, we go right to
the turnover differential.
Without a doubt, because when we see that, that pretty much tells the tale of the game. And I know there's still plenty of time to go, but you've got to take care of the football in order to win it.
Fields. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get four points. That is safety.
The goal here is about getting any kind of positive yardage in this spot because you don't care who, you don't care how. You just want to try and buy a little space and get away from your own end zone. But in this spot, the defense was all over that play and equally motivated to stick him with a safety.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here 1st and 10, just shy of the 30. They'll start with a handoff to Sanders. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, 2nd down. Justin Jones there on the stop. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. From the 31, Hurts. He's going to rifle one deep left side. He's got a man complete. And they're going to move it down to inside the 25.
I would say just add that one to the total big plays he's already made here in the first month of the year. You've got to think the front office and the coaching staff have got to be excited about what they've seen so far and really excited about what they expect to see down the road.
Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of 4. Throwing again on 2nd down. Hurts. And this is caught. It's Brown. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Hurts sets up to throw it. Steps away to his left. Throw across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jaquan Bisker, and the Bears will take over here at their own 12-yard line.
Well, I would guess they combined. If you spoke to both defenses, neither side has a lot to celebrate today. They haven't had a lot of stops, but that one right there, that's a big one because they stole points away with that play. Just as importantly, picked up a key stop on an offense that's been really impressive here in the early going.
Just a gain of a couple there, and it's second down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. To throw again on second down, Fields. He's got a man, complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Working with the lead, trying to get to 2-0. Here's first and 10. Here's Fields. And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Throwing again is Fields. Him in stride, and he will go out right near the 35-yard line. The Bears on the move. They've got another first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
To throw once more on second and 10, Fields. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
The first two drives yielded touchdowns, so there's no reason for them to feel like they have to pull back on the reins. They pushed it downfield, looking for another one right there. Didn't get it, but we know they're going to continue to be bold.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Eagles are going to get the football here at their own 23. This defense had three interceptions last week. They're on pace for more than that here, two in the first half.
Do not adjust your set. This is not instant replay. This is a defense that is locked in. They're essentially running the routes for the receivers and turning into the receivers themselves, aren't they? I mean, it's amazing what I'm seeing. Because the reaction to those guys back on the back seven, phenomenal.
So we reach halftime with the visiting Bears out on top here. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? This one fielded at the 5. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And Goddard's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Eagles have taken the lead here this third quarter. Extra point up and through, and the lead is up to five. Now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Taken in at the three. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
Now on second and 13, Fields. A throw left side taken in by Kmet. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He's been big. Two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. Now it's Fields. No gain on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Now it's Fields off the bootleg. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time. It's going to lead to third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch. Take the hit and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll get this up near midfield, but then still a few yards shy of the first down. So the completion good for seven there. And it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Snap it to Fields. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 16.
Well, Charles, just some visibly frustrated players and coaches on that sideline right now because those halftime adjustments didn't work. The turnover problems continuing here in the second half, and the defense now sitting pretty comfortably as a result of that pick six.
And that's a great observation too, Brandon, because they did make adjustments at halftime. But how about this other group staying a step ahead despite whatever happened in that other locker room? No surprise they're leading, and it's appropriate that those defenders got to add to the lead directly.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to pull your playmakers together.
So, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Another throw and second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Throwing on third down, Fields. That's complete to Mooney. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Fields to Mooney for the Chicago first.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Fields throwing again. Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring out second. And that's his second sack in this one.
And you just can't ask a defensive end or an edge rusher to play any better than what we're seeing right now. And partner, it's still just the third quarter. I'm thinking he's not done yet. Even if he's not getting the sack, he's bringing a lot of pressure to the pocket.
He's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain there of 30 big ones.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field. Pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route well run, and the football right on the money.
It sort of looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA. Play action is Fields. And that one going to come up short. Low throw. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with the short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
And he can only manage to take this thing to the 38, well shy of the first down. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. And he has got from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And that lead is back down to 9 now. So give him 3 on that drive. You know, normally you'd say, we'll take it. But the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
Let's go now.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime. If you're a good football team, you spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively. From the 24, Hurts. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Hurts going to give it to Sanders on the option. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Nasir Adderley that time making the tackle. The free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play? and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle.
Hurts throw taken in by Watkins here. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Partner, took a while for him to lock onto a receiver, and he finally found his man coming left to right across the formation. But by the time he got the ball to him, not much of a chance to turn upfield and make anything out of it.
And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And the Bears are going to take possession of the football. So a potential momentum shifter there, working with a two-score lead third quarter, but that not the smartest of throws.
I would agree with you on that one because this game is still very much in the balance. It felt pretty one-sided to this point, but now if these guys can turn this turnover into points, things could start getting a little more interesting.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has a real priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
And they try again with Montgomery. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. The second down play not much better than the first. Just a gain of 1 there.
Well, it's not time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Now Fields on third and goal. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick 16.
And that offense trying to erase that deficit, get a little bit closer here and climb back into this game in the third quarter. Instead, they further their disadvantage, Charles, with a pick 6.
And that defense came out willing to do anything necessary to defend that lead. I think they looked around the huddle and said, who's going to make the big play? Who's it going to be? And the person just ended up in the end zone with the football, he was the one that answered the bell.
No problem there on the extra point. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. This one fielded at the 5. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this year around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Back to throw, Fields. Over the middle, and that's caught by Kmet. That's a room to maneuver. Touchdown, Chicago! Well, that's pretty impressive, Charles. It's one thing to be an elite speed wide receiver and have all that yards after the catch into the end zone, but from your tight end?
Yeah, you don't get that very often. What you're describing is more like a Tyreek Hill, a Davante Adams, and Antonio Brown. You're not talking about a guy that lines up or can...
And it's intercepted at the goal line!
It's interesting that when it comes to two-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. Not much leg here. Fields this at the 23. And he got loose football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Looking at it from the defense's perspective, they could have really used the football to try to start eating into this deficit.
Yeah, because now possession's so crucial at this stage of the game. And when you've got an opportunity to hop on a turnover and you don't get it, I can feel the frustration all the way up here.
And the offense, they're living right now. Another bounce and break that goes their way.
Now, they did get a little gain on this play, but all in all, a nice job defensively against the touch pass. They were able to string it out towards the sideline and never let him get the corner and turn it upfield for a bigger chunk of yardage.
And some room to run now. And he takes this all the way down to the Bears 11.
125 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
Well, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there. But first down, Hurts.
And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need.
Picked up by Jalen Johnson. And the Bears are right back in this football game. They exited the pocket trying to improvise. That was a tough throw, and unfortunately, it wound up in the wrong pair of hands.
And Brandon, when you're on the run, sometimes your downfield vision can get skewed just a bit. Now, the beauty of extending a play is sometimes your receivers find their way open, but oftentimes you end up closing down part of the field and bringing those defenders to the ball, and that one was picked off.
So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that'll give them a short yardage situation here for second down. To the 33-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Now, yes, a 2-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right, they did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a 2-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Off play action. Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles 36. Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. From the 29, Fields. And again, back to Komet. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 12-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a one-score game. I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Going up the gut, Montgomery. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. David Montgomery, his first rushing touchdown on the year. And the Bears have made it a one-score game again here in the 4th. So what can the Bears do here as they'll go for 2. Fields trying to throw for it. It's complete. And he got it on the touchdown run, but he won't get in here. He'll be stopped short, and they'll come up empty on the try for 2. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chile on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. Because if there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Hurts. This will be caught by Brown. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Hurts connecting there with Brown for the Eagles first. Throwing is Hurts. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
It's a second down run to Sanders. And he'll be tackled at the 45 following a gain of just two.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead.
Ready, ready.
We'll see what they have drawn up here, a little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved.
Here we go.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game as now they've got it third and long. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And look at this, they get the turnover they needed, it's intercepted. Picked up by Jaquan Brisker, and the Bears are going to take possession of the football. Well, my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
I see you nodding your head up and down. That's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away, live to fight another down.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 5 yards, now it's third and five.
He's not quibble about the game there on second down. That's a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Back to throw, Fields. Oh, he's got him in wide open, complete. Touchdown. A great play there. 34 yards. And the Bears have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter.
Did you see them hold up four fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. Trying to run it in with my
Montgomery.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. Not much leg here. Fields this at the 24-yard line. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30.
Here we go, here we go.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. Ready? It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball. But
and at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. A big play there for Philly. And even 50 yards.
Okay,
the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. They'll run with Sanders. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Once again with Sanders. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they take it away late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow.
What a game this has been, and what a drive that was, Charles, to take the lead here late in the fourth quarter.
Partner, that's a job well done by everyone, from the players to the guys calling the plays. And if I may introduce just one downside to the mix, might be a little bit too much time left. Enough on the clock for a final last-ditch effort to try and steal this win away.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Offense ready to go for their next drive.
And the football changing hands here, and as this offense takes the field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for six.
And this
forces one there. It's a potential dagger as it's intercepted.
Picked up by Noah Igbinoghene. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. Now the extra point try forthcoming. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
And not the first time that they're coming back out off of a turnover, but the last one really hurt Charles with that pick six.
And it feels like the whole team's infected right now, doesn't it? It's not just been one person. It's kind of been a group effort where the mistakes have happened. Can they put that aside, kind of start over, and put together a nice drive?
Now to the middle, and it's complete. The Bears will use their third and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock.
Work to do here to avoid falling to 1-1, but this is first and 10 right now. A shotgun snap, Fields.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this ball incomplete. Looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. Second down coming up.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. A loss of three on the sack made by multiple defenders. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. We go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best, and I think that's what we saw for both.